Guess what sucks today?
Ubisoft games, apparently. Because I was playing The Crew. Because I don't know why. It's Grindfest. And I ground for the Rayman texture because I don't know, I thought that'd be cool. And I go to put black on it because I think that might be cool too. And oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. You didn't even check for this kind of thing, did you, Ubisoft? You just put it out there because you wanted to get your product placement in. In your own game, you needed more product placement, and you put the texture in, and you didn't even bother to bug check it. Oh my goodness. Ubi, you fucking hacks. You fucking hacks. Well, more content for the other video I was making. Alright. I've been doing this race for almost an hour now. We're gonna talk about Ubisoft. Because, you know, driving is fucking boring. This game is called The Crew. The Crew was released not recently at all, really. A few years ago. And runs pretty well. It was an alright idea, which was making a driving game where it was basically an MMO, and you could play with your friends and all that junk, and you could drive together in giant herds across the great American Midwest, etc., etc. Why'd they have to give that idea to Ubisoft? My main problem with Ubisoft is pretty much what Jim Sterling has said multiple times. They tend to make giant expanses of open world with absolutely nothing to do with them. Oh, and don't forget the iconic Ubisoft analogs for radio towers in every single one of the games. Like, in this game, you get fucking satellite dishes. That's right. In this game, the cops do not come after you for driving your car up to frigging satellite dishes. What? There's even one that's in the giant field of radio antennas out in, like, Nevada or whatever. I can't remember where that is. You can see one up over the hill past the trees. Back there, I think that's Pike's Peak, actually. Or at least this game's analog to Pike's Peak. I'm pretty sure they call it Pike's Peak. Another thing with this game, they have the purse strings on the in-game currency. Like, this is a Ubisoft thing as well. But it seems to be, like, everybody's thing nowadays. You get some kind of in-game currency, which you barely get any of, and you get, like, $8,000 or so off of finishing a really short race that you could do in like under 10 minutes. But one, that's 10 minutes, and two, that's only 8,000 points. When some of the cars can cost up to over a million of these points. I get really silent when I concentrate. It's driving trance or something.
I've done this in Trackmania Turbo as well, which is another Ubisoft travesty. Well, it's not that bad, but whatever. I'm going off on a tangent. Look, along with being tight on the purse strings, they have this side currency, which you can buy for real money, fucking play money, that you can buy for real money, like fucking gift cards. Oh, you wanna spend cash? Well, you can only do it with our specific in-game credits, etc., etc. There we go. Alright, for this almost an hour of driving, I have gotten... Let's see here. Challenge completed. I have gotten... a shitty smart loot, which is not going to be a part I need. Unless it is. Oh, it is! That's a first. Oh, wait! It's basically a direct analog to another part I already have. Thanks. Thanks, smart loot. They call it smart loot. It's not that smart. But yeah, I get these bucks, which are used to purchase things in-game, and I, for almost an hour of driving and finishing in the top three of this almost an hour race, I get 88,000 bucks. This game is grindy as hell, and there's really no purpose for it. It just causes me to not want to play anymore, is the deal. Because it's boring. You go out and you play this game. Oh, look, I want that thing. You gotta grind for like 8 hours. A game should not be an analog to real life. I'm saying analog a lot in this video. A game should not emulate real life that closely. Because if you emulate it too closely, you just want to hit escape and get out and go actually do real life. Because at least then you're making some real dinero. Robert De Niro. This is getting kind of... It's just getting to be kind of a problem, because... It's like every game wants to be this. It wants to be this... nebulous, stupid, boring, mess. I remember huge amounts of fanboys would come and try to defend The Division, which was a crapshoot. A terrible crapshoot. It was boring. It was tedious. It was dull and bland. There was really nothing defining it as opposed to other third-person shooters of the genre. And this is a problem with Ubisoft. It really does nothing different. It's like a lot of AAA companies these days. And it's just sitting hunkered down in this little bunker of safety and not wanting to go out of its comfort zone. I know innovative is kind of a destroyed word these days, but come on. This was a great idea. If you didn't stay in your comfort zone of overpriced DLC and massively multiplayer online shit, and having always online DRM for some strange reason, even though this game has a single player campaign in it. Well, it can be played with friends, but you get the idea. I don't get game companies these days. It's just a crapshoot. And I will have a review of Trackmania Turbo up sometime soon. I just gotta find the motivation and artistic drive to actually do it. Oh well. That's me done.